targeted individuals. What's going on? It's your boy Next Level here, man. Back at it again on another video for y'all. Today I'm feeling a little stuffy, man. I don't know. I've been sneezing and coughing, you know. But I'm definitely gonna get over this thing. You know, God is with me. God is with you. But today I want to talk about the technology that they have and the things that I've went through. The V2K, I want to get a little in depth in that just to give you guys some kind of idea of my story and what I went through. So back in, I want to say 2010, I started noticing a lot of, I don't know, I thought cops was following me. Like, I thought I was, like, under investigation for something. Like, everywhere I went, like, my Jeep, like, I would pull out the driveway, and as soon as I would take off, I lived in an apartment complex at the time, and as soon as I would take off driving, bam, they was following me, and then, like, T.I., you know, when you're driving your car, and they follow you, they get right up on you. And they flash their beam. So I started noticing that. And even before that, like, I kind of think the girl that I was with, I kind of think she was in on the targeting, because like, we lived together at the time. Actually, I had a place. I had my own place. Used to come by. We used to hang out and, you know, do stuff. But it was some other shady things going on with her. Like, I mean, as the story will run on, I don't want to give y'all like a 50-minute video right now. Just want to basically give y'all some information and, you know, just let y'all know a couple things that I went through. So that'll be another video. But when we moved in together, one day I came home from work, and there were like people in our apartment, some guys like installing some kind of stuff. I didn't order anything, like I didn't know why they was installing, and now that I look back, it makes sense. But they were installing some kind of equipment, and she was there, like she knew fully like what was going on. So I went, I was trying to go to a music school. I wanted to sign up for this music school, and I was all excited about that. And I was writing and recording, and I was up for like 3 days writing and recording. And upon that third day, now mind you, like, I've always done this. Like, I've always stayed up. Like, I'm really passionate about music. I'm passionate about, you know, what I do. That's a whole nother video right there as well. But on the third day, as I was writing, I started hearing voices. Now, the voices that I heard, they weren't voices that I was familiar with at that point, but it was like they were commenting on the material that I was creating. Like, they were like, oh, you're writing this about her, and blah, 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 like, and being really nasty and saying nasty things. So I was like, okay, I turned the music off, and I stopped, and then my girlfriend at the time, who I look, well, ex-girlfriend now, but she told me to eat something, because I hadn't eaten anything. I was just up writing and recording. I was going hard. So she told me to eat a piece of celery, and I swear, I don't know what it was, but I ate that piece of celery, and boom, the floodgates opened as far as the V2K. Like, I started hearing, it sounded like it was a hate-a-thon going on, actually. I heard voices, and it sounded like they were doing shifts. Like, they were somewhere sitting in a broadcast room, and everybody was sitting around just talking about me. Like, there were people who I used to be cool with, people that, who I fell out with, like, and I can honestly look back and say they were all perps. Like, they weren't, I wasn't really cool with them. They were just perping at the time. But I heard them. I heard people who I didn't know. They were like orchestrating some kind of event. I call it a hate-a-thon inside my mind. And I'm sitting there, and they could hear my thoughts. Okay, so I'm sitting there bugging out, like, what the, you know, I'm like almost in a state of panic because this has never happened. This is the first time a V2K hit. It was 2010. And I'm sitting there, and they're like, blah, blah, blah. Oh, we're going to kill you. Oh, we're going to such and such. F you. You effing this and that. Like, just saying really, like, terrible things to say. You know, that went on for the whole night. I mean, girls that I knew, it was so many different voices that I heard. Okay, I'm not sure if this happened to any other TI before, but this was one of the worst days of my life. Like, it really was. Like, how that worked out. I heard people that I knew, like my mom, like my brother, like my perps, friends, like, and they were all just sitting there conversing, and it was their voice, like, you know what I mean? Like, if it's somebody you know their voice. And I heard it, and they took turns, like, they all took turns telling me how they felt, you know, F me, you know, I should die, and they're gonna kill me, and such, and just going over and over and just saying really negative and bad things. So that went on for the rest of the night. It just kept going. It kept on going. Like, it didn't stop. I'm going to tell you how it ended. It really ended bad. I called my older brother because I thought there were people outside. Like, the voices, this, like, went from the night to the day. And I thought there were people outside the house, and they had my house around it, and they were coming in to kill me. That's what I kept hearing. Oh, we're gonna do this and that. Now, mind you, I'm sitting in the house. I got a loaded, I think it was an SK maybe, or AK rifle, loaded, strapped, ready to shoot anything that walked through the door, you know, anything like. And I, in my heart, I felt like my ex-girlfriend was in on it, and she knew what was happening. Because, you know, as a, if I, you know, if I'm with somebody, like, if I'm with you, and you come to me and say, baby, I'm hearing voices, like, I'm gonna be like, whoa, what's going on? Like, you know, I'm not gonna just perp, like, because I felt like she was perping, man, like, she was adding it on and making it worse. So I called my older brother, and he came with a cousin of ours, and I'm like freaking out, oh no, they outside and blah blah blah, I'm gonna kill him. I had the gun, and he was like, give me the gun, and he tried to take the gun from me. I'm like, no, we go outside, blah blah blah. They're like, yo, nobody is outside, but I can hear these voices, like, full-fledged on, like, the voices was going, like, and it was just like I said, it was like a hate-a-thon. It was some moderators, like whoever was the handlers or whatever, they were like mediating, like giving everybody a chance to just basically, you know, but it really messed me up inside because it was really those people's voices, like people that I knew, like, and people that I didn't know, I didn't recognize them, but that's the way it was, like an event, like they hosted an event, you know, and I was the guest of honor, basically, you know what I mean? So, they took me over my cousin's house. They took the gun from me, took me over my cousin's house, and I'm sitting there, I'm still freaking out, and I'm hearing all kinds of crazy stuff, like, I mean, unbelievable stuff, and at the same time, I started getting memories that I didn't even know that was, you know, like, okay, we'll be right back. My phone is ringing. I gotta answer that.